Yo, what's up guys? This is how you can create neon lights from images and texts, which looks good on both EEVEE and cycles. For this example, I'm going to create a very simple scene with a crappy building with a storefront. I'll be using EEVEE to show you things you need to set up to get a good looking result. I also added very little light so you can see the neon lights affecting its surroundings. Alright, let's add a text, move it in front of the store's window, and let's pretend it's a coffee shop. Now, the font is not looking good, so go to the text tab and click on regular font and load a proper font. You can download the font I'm using from the description. Now, let's add a solidify modifier so it's not totally flat. Now, add a material and change its shader to an emission shader. I'm gonna go with a classic orange light with a strength set to 15. You might be wondering why it's not glowing. That's because you need to enable bloom in the render tab. You may also wanna enable screen space reflections to enable reflections in the glossy materials. Now, this is not casting light to its surrounding objects. That's because EEVEE is a real-time render engine and will not calculate emission lighting. To fix this, you need to add a light probe. Shift A and in light probe menu, select irradiance volume. Scale it up and go into the render tab, scroll down until you find indirect lighting and then click bake. Once it's baked, you can see it's casting light. Alright, that's it for the text. Now let's add an image. You can use any image and as long as it's black and transparent, it's gonna work. If you're using Inkscape, it's as simple as importing a PNG file and saving it as an SVG. And then you can import it into Blender. For this example, I'm gonna draw this cup of coffee myself and then I'm gonna save it as an SVG. And then I'm going to import it into Blender. Now, when importing SVG files in Blender, chances are it's too small. So you need to scale every single part of your drawing up. Now, select every single part and go to Object, Convert, Mesh. And now, with all of them selected, Control J to join them all together. Also, set the origin to geometry since we have no faces yet. Tab into edit mode and extrude all vertices so we have some faces. With all faces selected, Control F and solidify faces and then adjust the thickness. Now let's assign the material we created for the text to this image as well. And now it's looking good. To finish off, I'm gonna add a curvature to the text. Add a bezier curve, align it with the text, and edit it. Then select the text in the text tab, scroll down till you find text on curve, and with the eyedropper, select the bezier curve. If you try to scale it, it will scale to its origin, and it will try to fit the curve. Convert it into a mesh, so you can scale it properly. And that's it. For a physically accurate result, you can use cycles, but I think EEVEE works just fine. If you found this video useful, make sure to give it a like, and I will see you in another video.